The occupancy rate in most private hospitals in the Philippines is still manageable despite an increase in COVID-19 hospitalizations. That's according to the president of the Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines. Dr. Jose Rene de Grano says the occupancy rate in most private hospitals ranges from 40% to 50%, except in some areas in Metro Manila and Central Visayas.
Hindi pa naman tayo ano nasa critical level right now, no? Tumaas po talaga ng mga at least around 15% yung admissions ng mga COVID cases, pero yung pong mga grabe hindi naman po nag-o-occupy halos ng mga ICU ganon. So lalo na po sa buong Pilipinas po, actually mga around 40 to 50% ang occupancy.
The Health Department has said there has been an increase in COVID-19 admissions in hospitals in Metro Manila, Cagayan Valley, and Central Visayas. But it says the capacity of public and private medical facilities in these areas are still under moderate risk level. Some state-run hospitals in Metro Manila in need of more medical professionals to handle the rising number of COVID-19 cases. As Angel Movido tells us, even health workers working in non-COVID-19 wards are getting infected.
The East Avenue Medical Center in Quezon City is bracing for a possible surge in COVID-19 cases. But health workers are already swamped with walk-in patients coming from various parts of Metro Manila after some hospitals temporarily closed their emergency and outpatient departments due to the rising COVID cases.
Dati kasi, on a daily basis, meron kaming admitted na patients na 2 hanggang 3. Pero itong huling 7 araw, tumaas ito at ngayon, meron kaming 15 confirmed COVID cases na admitted ngayon sa hospital. All in all, nakakita kami ng mga 10 to 15% na pagtaas.
Nunez says COVID cases have been recorded among health workers, even for those working in non-COVID wards.
Lumalabas sila kasi sa community nila na-expose sila sa mga gatherings ng mga tao and yung mga crowded places. Ito yung nakita namin na common sa kanilang mga storya. No? At dahil dito, muli ay ini-encourage namin ang mga komunidad na magkaroon ng mga minimum health standards.
The Lung Center of the Philippines has a similar situation.
We also get it from the workplace, not necessarily from our COVID areas. Ha? Kasi yung mga COVID areas namin, talagang maingat na maingat kami. And everyone is conscious there. Talagang full protection. Ang problema ngayon, yung mga non-COVID areas, kasi kahit doon, maraming mga nagkakahawahan ngayon, aside from the community.
On Monday, hospital officials have reported an increase in cases, with isolation areas and ICU beds almost full.
Ngayon, yung ibang rooms, para lang maka-accommodate kami ng more patients, pinagsasama-sama namin yung tinatawag na cohorting of all confirmed cases. So yung dalawahan, tatluhan. Nung araw, iniiwasan talaga namin yan eh.
Oo.
But we have no choice now.
Both hospitals gave the assurance their facilities can handle a surge in cases. But East Avenue Medical Center admits they need more nurses.
Meron pa rin kaming deficit around 30 to 35 nurses na kailangan pa namin punuan. Pero ang issue sa amin ay wala kasing nag-a-apply at the moment.
The Philippine Hospital Association also admits the lack in manpower, saying the demand for non-hospital posts for nurses also increased in different government agencies.
Kino-close down nila yung mga nurse stations dahil sa kulang ng nurse, minimintin lang yung about 50%. Sa dating capacity.
The Lung Center of the Philippines appeals for the public's cooperation.
Crucial itong darating na 1 or 2 weeks.
Mm-mm.
Kaya nga inaalerto nating maigi yung public eh. At a time na nagko-consider ang mga taong ay andyan na yung vaccine, pwede nang lumuwag o pwede na tayong bumalik sa dati.
Mm-mm.
Hindi pa talaga.
For Dr. Antonio Danz of the Healthcare Professionals Alliance Against COVID-19 or HPAC, aside from public compliance, the government has to work on better policies.
Ang importante yung ano, enabling measures. Kasi madaling sabihin sa tao magdistansya eh kung siksikan sa ano, sa sasakyan and they have to work, paano yun? Kasalanan ba nila yan o sa policy maker?
A survey released by the Okta Research Group reveals 9 out of 10 Filipinos wear face masks and practice hand washing to curb the spread of the virus. While fewer comply with the wearing of face shields and maintaining physical distancing, experts also recommend open-air activities such as going to parks and alfresco dining instead of going to indoor venues. Angel Movido, ABS-CBN News.
A number of local officials have reimposed lockdowns and curfews in parts of Metro Manila, where the number of coronavirus infections has hit a six-month high. Rafi Santos reports.
COVID-19 cases continue to spike in Metro Manila, with over 1,600 new cases logged on Monday. The Metro's total made up half of the country's new cases, its fifth consecutive day with over 1,000 fresh infections. According to data from ABS-CBN, the numbers also hit highs not seen since September 15, 2020. Pasay City remains one of the COVID-19 hotspots, with 83 new cases Monday.
Nagulat kami, 100 plus every day. Sa ngayon po, na ginagawa po, palo lang kami minsan ng 60, 70 to 80 new cases. So sa tingin ko, bumababa po.
City officials are stepping up surveillance of thickly populated barangays while strictly enforcing minimum health standards. Muntinlupa City, which has one of the lowest active cases in Metro Manila, is not letting its guard down.
Kailangan po kasi talaga mag-igit po tayo ngayon dahil kailangan pong protektahan po natin ang syudad. So yung mga curfew po na implementation ay kailangan po matisagawa.
One of government's immediate actions to rising coronavirus cases is the deployment of more policemen and civilian auxiliaries to implement minimum health standards amid what is considered as COVID-19 fatigue. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority says they will also hire and provide additional contact tracers to cities that need them.
It's been 1 year now since we had this lockdown on March 17. It is called, of course, COVID fatigue. Medyo hindi na nga tama, nakaganito, nakalabas na rito, nagmaskara pa,
nakaganito.
May mga ganon. But one thing is, we are most vulnerable habang kumakain tayo. Because when we eat, wala naman talaga mask eh.
Yes.
At kumisa nangyayari sa mga offices, kakain, parang salo-salo na eh, dahil kampante na sa ka-opisina eh.
Yeah.
Or better yet, no, maski siguro yung mga magkakamag-anak na, kaya kung papansin ninyo yung mga ano yung clustering, talagang pamilya.
The PNP says public places will be under increased surveillance to ensure people adhere to health protocols.
Yung public display of affection, kasama din po yan, no? Kasi alam naman po natin, dahil nag-reopen for a while economy, marami pong mga namamasyal, marami pong mga tao na sadya talagang na-miss din nila yung kanilang pagsasamahan. At of course, yung mga young professionals, it appears na sila po yung mas mataas ang bilang ng mga nahawaan ito pong last week.
The Metro Manila Council is set to convene a meeting to discuss the recent surge in COVID-19 cases, which will then form the basis of their recommendations to the President. In the meantime, local executives are taking steps to curb further infections. Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno has placed 3 villages on lockdown, including 2 hotels, namely the Malate Bayview Mansion and Hop Inn Hotel in Barangay 699. Moreno adds, villages with 10 cases or more will be placed under localized lockdown, where mobility will be strictly regulated. Quezon City is also placing several areas under a 14-day special concern lockdown. In nearby San Juan City, the local government is imposing new curfew hours starting Tuesday, also in a bid to keep COVID numbers down. The citywide curfew hours will begin at 10 in the evening until 5 in the morning. Some of those exempted from curfew are health workers and frontline personnel, delivery services, and employees from both government and private companies returning home or heading to work. Rafi Santos, ABS-CBN News.